Welcome to the video tutorial section for eHRAF World Cultures. I'm Elisa Jordan, and I'll be your guide. In this video, you will learn how to navigate through the culture profile in eHRAF World Cultures. First, we'll start at the main page, where we find Browse Cultures. Click on Browse Cultures. Let's say I'm interested in exploring the eHRAF World Cultures file on Navajo society. I'll type in Navajo. Here, right under Navajo, we see three menus appear: Culture Summary, Collection Description, and Collection Documents. First, let's talk about Collection Descriptions. These contain culture descriptions, collection information, and collection indexing notes. The culture description is written by eHRAF staff. Culture descriptions provide the name of the culture, geographic region details, OWC identifiers, and a single paragraph about the culture. Here I find that Navajo are the second largest Native American group in North America, located in the Southwest and Basin region. The OWC code for Navajo is NT13. The collection information describes how many documents and pages we have corresponding to that culture in our files. It also features a brief overview by a eHRAF anthropologist summarizing the sorts of holdings we have for each culture. The Navajo file is robust, and eHRAF has indexed over 250 documents on the Navajo and nearly 30,000 pages. If necessary, collection indexing notes describe how subject content was indexed inside the documents. Within the collection indexing notes for Navajo groups, I see that eHRAF indexed the political grouping known as chapters within the OCM identifier 631, and eHRAF indexed code talkers during World War II as part of OCM identifier 708. The culture summary is a very valuable resource in eHRAF World Cultures. Culture summaries offer brief overviews of cultures in our collections, and nearly every culture has a summary prepared. Most summaries are adapted from the 10-volume encyclopedia Outline of World Cultures that eHRAF produced. Within each summary, you will find a standardized set of information about each culture, covering everything from population size to economy to social organization. Culture summaries are browsable here and also searchable, meaning that they will show up in search results in eHRAF. They are indexed by OCM identifier, with OCM identifiers for each paragraph located in a column to the left of the text as a copper-colored and clickable font, which brings up general information about the OCM subject, including broader terms and examples. The first thing we see in culture summary, right below the author's names, in this case William Adams, are other common names for Navajo groups. Then we come to a section titled Orientation. This covers general information on identification of Navajo groups, spatial locations, demography, language, and general historical information, where I find that the Navajo and Apache, originally hunters and foragers, likely migrated to the Southwest in the past 1,000 years. Settlement information is located directly below this category. This is followed by a section on economy. Here, it introduces me to subsistence and commercial activities, such as the Navajo dependence on maize and the growth of wage labor. I find information on industrial arts as well, such as the long-standing tradition of weaving and pottery making. I also learn a bit about trade here and the importance of Pueblo communities and trade posts. Going down, I read about historical division of labor and how this has changed over time. The next categorical division is for kinship, where I learn about matrilineal clans and exogamous marriage practices. And that brings us to our next section on detailed marriage and family practices. Information on residence patterns is located here as well, in the form of the domestic unit, which in this case is usually a nuclear biological family. I find out about patterns of inheritance, as well as child socialization methods and child rearing approaches. Moving on, we find socio-political organization data. This includes social ranking among family groups. Political organization, the next subsection, was largely informal in Navajo society, and social control was informal but powerful, emphasizing the collectivity of the group. Next, we move into data on religion and expressive culture. We start with the beliefs. Religious practitioners, the next subsection, highlights the importance of ceremonial singers who can conduct entire ceremonies and are highly respected within Navajo communities, often acting as informal leaders. Moving on, I come to general information about medicine, finding that ceremonies are often medicinal in nature, and medicine is ceremonial in nature. The section beneath this, Death and the Afterlife, explains how the Navajo handle the dead and also includes information about Navajo beliefs and attitudes of the dead. At the very close of the summary is the bibliography cited by the authors of the culture summary. For the final part of this video, let's close this cultural summary and take a look at the Collection Documents tab. Here you will see all of the documents pertaining to the culture in eHRAF. You can sort these by the author's last name, document title, or publication date by clicking on the column headers. We can also click on the document title in this list to go to the publication information page for that document. And that's where we'll find a great deal of metadata and information about not only the document itself, but also how eHRAF managed it. Well, that's it for the culture summary tutorial. We hope this tutorial was helpful for you. Check out our other tutorials and stay in the loop or contact us by checking out our homepage and linking up with us on Facebook and Twitter.